click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, welcome back to another video from the chapter Logic Gates. So today we are going to see how the full adder is constructed with the help of the gate and the basic circuit for the full adder. So let's start with the topic full adder. So in the previous sections, we have seen that in the half adder, it can perform only the addition of the two bits. But what if we have the more than two bits number? So it can't be performed using the two adder, half adder circuit. So that's why what we are going to do is we are using the full adder circuit. So in the full adder circuit, we can perform the addition of the three bits number. And also the drawback was half adder was it can't take the carry of the previous stage. So that's why in the full adder circuit, we can take the carry of the previous stage to the next stage. So, full adder circuit is basically used to perform the addition of the 3-bit number. That is, it can perform the 3-bit addition. So, whenever we want to construct the circuit, we always have to form the truth table. So, from the truth table, we can get the equation, and from the equation itself, we can construct the full adder circuit with the help of the gate. So, let's see the truth table. Now here we want to perform the 3-bit addition. Therefore we have three inputs, that is input A, input B and the input C. Now we have considered the different cases, that is A, B, C, and these are the 8 different cases. So first of all we have taken as 4 zeros, 4 1, then 2 zeros, 2 1s, 2 zeros, 2 1 and then alternate 0, 1, 0, 1. So here we are going to perform the binary addition. So right now I'm directly going to write the sum and the carry, because in the previous sections you can refer the videos from the playlist. So in that video I have mentioned how to perform the binary addition. So here I will directly write down the values of sum and carry. Now let's see the sum and carry. So I have directly written here the value. So it is very simple, that is A plus B will give you 0 and B plus C will again give you 0. So here no carry is present. So that's why carry is equal to 0. So let's take another example of here. Okay, so A plus B, that is 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, and 1 plus 1 is 0, but carry will be 1. Okay, so that's why we have got here the value of carry is 1. So similarly, you can see this. So this is nothing but a simple binary addition. Just refer the previous video. So now, what we are going to do is, we are going to construct the basic gate circuits for this truth table. But to construct the circuit with the help of the truth table, what we need is, we need some equation. So to form the equation, what we will do is, first of all, we will see for which input conditions we are getting the carry output as a 1. So here, if you see this, here we are getting the two values. Here for this condition, we are getting the value of carry is 1. So again, for this condition, we are getting the value of 1 here. So now this condition also, we are getting the carry is 1. Now again for this. Okay. So if you consider these cases, in this case, you can see we are getting the carry of 1 when the value of B and C is 1, 1. Then again, we are getting the carry 1 when the value of A and C is 1, 1. Again, we are getting 1 when value of A and B is 1. Then again, A when A, B, C, that is 1. So what we are going to do is, we can means overview that the value of carry is high when A, B, B, C, and CA, this CA we have taken here, C and A, and ABC, ABC, these values are 1. So we have got the condition that when AB is equal to 1, that means multiplication, 1 into 1, 1. Okay, so this, when these values are 1, the carry is 1. Now, but we have to write down for the sum. So for the sum, what we will do is, for the sum, it is a very simple thing. We have performed the addition. How we have performed the addition is, what we have did is, we have taken the AB plus BC plus CA. So similarly, you can perform the addition. Okay, if we consider for the sum, this is AB plus BC plus AC. Now let's verify it from the truth table, okay? Value of AB. A into B, 0 into 0 is 0. Plus BC, 0 into 0 is 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0, it will give 0. Now let's take the another condition. Second condition, that is value of A is 0, value of B is 0 and value of C is 1. So 0 into 0 will give 0. BC, so 0 into 1 will give us 0. And AC, 0 into 1 will give us 0. So the output will be 1. Okay. Now let's check this condition. Okay. So here the A is 0. So A into B. So 0 into 1 is 0. Now BC. 1 into 1 is 1. Now AC. 0 into 1 is 0. This is the 1. So see. So now we have seen from this condition we are getting values. These are satisfied. Because AB plus BC plus AC is satisfied for all these 8 conditions. That's why we can directly write down this condition for the sum. Similarly, for the carry, AB, BC, C and ABC are 1 when the carry is high. So this condition is also satisfying for all the equation. So right now it is clear that from this equation we can construct the circuit for the sum. And from this condition we can construct the circuit for carry. So let's construct this. Now we are going to see how the circuit is constructed. Here we have 3 inputs, therefore we will draw the 3 lines. Okay, so though we have A, B and C. Now we want to represent the sum and carry. In the carry we have seen we have taken AB, BC, CA. Okay, so that's why what we will do, AB, BC and AC. Now we want to add this. So what we will do is we will simply add it using the OR gate. So this is the condition for the carry. Now for the sum. For sum, what we will do is we used to add A plus B then B plus C. Okay. So here we can perform the addition using the simply XOR gate. This is the sum. So my final equation will be, this is AB, BC. And this is AC. This will be A, B and C. So for the carry, we will have the equation AB plus BC plus AC. And for the sum, we will have A, B and C. So this is the final equations of the carry and sum for the full adder. But now, how we will represent the full adder in the form of circuit? So this is the circuit. Now what we will do is, so this is our full adder circuit. So in the full adder circuit, we have 3 inputs, that is A, B and C. But remember here the third input, that is the third input, can be written as carry input. And here we will get the output as sum. And this is carry. So in this circuit, you will represent the circuit that we have seen in the previous. Okay, so A and B will be the 2 inputs and this will be the carry input. Okay, C will be the carry input and this carry input will be forwarded to the next stage. Therefore, in the full adder circuit, this is the carry output, this is the sum, these are the 2 inputs and this is the carry input. So, this is how the full adder circuit can be constructed and we can use this circuit to perform the binary addition of the 3 bits number. So thank you friends for watching today's video. We will see the different types of binary additions, binary subtractions, also the different types of combinational circuit. These circuits, full adder and half adder, has nothing but the combinational circuit. So we will see different types of circuit using full adder and half adder in the next video. So stay tuned to Ekida channel and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.